How do I encrypt a folder? Sometimes encrypting a single file just isn't enough. Sometimes you want to encrypt all of the files in a folder and its subfolders. As you might imagine, there are several solutions depending on your particular needs. I'm going to review some alternatives as well as their pros and cons. Of course, the first thing we think of is using Windows to encrypt files and folders. If you're running Windows Pro and your disk is formatted using NTFS, as most are these days, then Windows can encrypt your files and/or folders using EFS, or the Encrypting File System. Right-click on the file or folder you want to encrypt, and I'm going to do that here with my Sensitive Data folder. Click on Properties, then click on Advanced. That's where this is all hidden. Here you can see that it says Encrypt Contents to Secure Data. That's the magic. As soon as we hit OK or Apply, then it's going to ask us if we want to apply the changes only to this folder, or if this folder also has other folders within it, should it apply to all of those subfolders and files within those? My thinking generally is if I want to encrypt a folder, I don't want there to be any question about it. I want it to be everything. I want it to be everything in that folder today, tomorrow, if I create subfolders, add files, whatever. So we'll go ahead and click OK. And of course, we should back up the key. Back up now. This is an important step to making sure you can recover these files from this encrypted hard drive later should something go wrong. Basically, we export it in an interesting format, and of course, we have to protect what we're saving since it is ultimately the key to unlocking everything. I'm just going to use a password, and we will save that somewhere interesting. And you can see here we have my encryptionkey.pfx. This is something you would save somewhere else to make sure that, again, should there be a problem in the future, you might be able to recover your encrypted data. I rarely actually do this step. And the reason is because I back up my data. I don't rely on my hard disk. If something goes wrong, I'm going to recover these files from the backup, and that backup will not be encrypted. Which actually brings us to some of the pros and cons. The good news of using this particular type of encryption is that it's simple, it's easy, it's almost completely transparent. Your folder is encrypted, as are the files that it contains. As long as you're not logged in, anyone who steals or otherwise gains access to your hard drive cannot gain access to that folder. The bad news. Anyone, including malware, who can access your computer while you're logged in, can access your files. All right, let's try a different approach. Let's talk about VeraCrypt. I'm going to go over to the VeraCrypt website just so that you can see it. VeraCrypt is a successor to the once very popular TrueCrypt. It has a couple of different approaches to high-quality encryption, one of which we can use to encrypt a folder. Or at least we can do something very, very similar. You can use VeraCrypt to create an encrypted container secured with a passphrase. This is a single encrypted file kept on your computer's hard drive. You then mount that file using VeraCrypt, supplying the passphrase to decrypt it. Once mounted, the unencrypted contents of that file appear as a separate drive, often called a virtual drive, on your system, reading data to and from that virtual drive transparently, decrypts and encrypts the data stored in the container. Once the drive is unmounted, the data is once again inaccessible without remounting the container and providing the passphrase. I'll give you a very, very quick run-through. Now, I already have VeraCrypt installed on this system. We'll click on Create Volume, create an encrypted file container, a standard VeraCrypt volume. Volume location, this is the file we're creating. I'm going to go ahead and put that in documents, and I'm going to call it my VeraCrypt vault dot, apparently HC is the one of the extensions that's fairly standardly used with these. I'm not exactly sure why. Encryption algorithms, fine. Hash algorithm is fine. The defaults are good. Here's where you specify the size. Now I have 98 gigabytes available. I'm going to go ahead and create a 5 gigabyte VeraCrypt volume. Here's where you specify the passphrase. I'm going to type something very short because I'm lazy. You, of course, would type something more appropriately secure depending on the level of security you're looking for this vault. Click on next. Yes, I know. Large files. Do you intend to store files larger than 4 gigabytes? No, in my case, no. And in general, you probably don't need to worry about this. My guess is you're probably never going to do something that large. This is now where it is collecting what it's calling randomness. It's basically using my mouse movements to make a really random number. Randomness is important when it comes to encryption. While it's doing that, I'm going to go ahead and change the file format, the file system, to be NTFS, because I'm only going to use this particular vault on a Windows system. We'll click on Format. And it's been created. We can now exit. Now we're going to locate the volume, my VeraCrypt vault, open it, and click on Mount. We'll select a drive letter to use for it. I'll use M for this. And we'll click on Mount. This is where you specify the password. So far, that vault is sitting there encrypted, and the only way to gain access to it is to do this, to actually mount it with the password we specify. And it mounts the volume. The net result is that that volume is going to show up as drive letter M on this machine. Local disk M. Now, encrypting a file is actually pretty straightforward. We will take a random file from my documents, say that sensitive data folder that we did earlier, and I'm simply going to copy it, go over to drive M, and paste it. This copies the information in that folder and everything within it. Now, I can go back to my documents folder if I want to and completely delete the sensitive data folder. I now have it in a VeraCrypt mounted volume. As soon as I dismount that volume, unmount, the data is no longer accessible. It's just that one encrypted vault that contains everything. Now that you know kind of sort of what it looks like, let's talk about pros and cons. VeraCrypt provides really high quality encryption and is available on multiple platforms. Containers you create using VeraCrypt are not tied to your login, but they're secured by a passphrase. The containers can be copied from machine to machine and opened anywhere. Once mounted, encryption and decryption are completely transparent to any program reading and writing data on the virtual drive. The bad news. Containers are monolithic, meaning that regardless of how many files they contain, they are still a single container file. We could take a quick look here at the documents and see that, yeah, here's my VeraCrypt volume, but if we scooch things over so that we can see the size, it's 5 gigabytes. It's holding a tiny amount of data, right? My secure BitLocker key, I think, is what I threw in there. And yet, the vault takes up 5 gigabytes. The container size, like I said, it's fixed when you create it, except you can, apparently, increase the size. You cannot make it smaller. The only way to move encrypted data from one place to another in its encrypted form is to copy the entire container. All right, that's VeraCrypt. Let's talk about Cryptomator. Cryptomator is similar to VeraCrypt, but it's designed to work specifically with online cloud services. Now, you can use it locally if you want to. That's the thing I think a lot of people don't quite realize. But the difference is that rather than storing everything in a single huge container, Cryptomator maintains everything as individually encrypted files. When you install and configure Cryptomator, you point it at an empty folder on your machine, which will then contain the encrypted data. And you specify, again, a passphrase for the encryption. You mount that folder using Cryptomator and your chosen passphrase. Much like VeraCrypt, a virtual drive appears. Files and folders transparently written to and read from that virtual drive are encrypted and stored within the folder you originally specified. Once you unmount the folder, only the encrypted copies remain accessible. The major difference between Cryptomator and VeraCrypt is that Cryptomator maintains the encrypted files and folders just as individual files and folders rather than using this single monolithic container. Let me show you quickly Cryptomator. All right, I'm going to run Cryptomator. Automatically checked for updates? Certainly. Click here to add a vault. That's what we're doing. Create a new vault. Choose a name for the vault. Click on Next. Custom location. I want this to be in my documents folder also, because why not? We'll click on Next. I'm going to skip the expert settings for now. Again, needs a passphrase. This, again, they call it a password, and I'm going to be very lazy. It's not a fair password. It's a crap password. Let's see. You won't be able to access your data. Do you want a recovery key? My recommendation is that you do this, that you save this. If you're going to use Cryptomator, much like we did with original Windows encryption, save these kinds of recovery keys just in case. With luck, you'll never, ever need it. But at some point in the future, if you ever do, you'll be glad you did. So we'll create vaults. This is the recovery key to restore access. Their recovery key is just text, which I find fascinating. I've copied it to the clipboard. I'm going to run Notepad, and I'm going to save this somewhere. For now, same thing. Cryptomator recovery key. The fact that you can see it, by the way, is irrelevant. I'm pretty sure that the key is going to change from time to time, each iteration. And what I'm creating here, honestly, it's an example. I'm going to get rid of it as soon as we're done anyway. So, click on Next. Added vault. We need to unlock the vault. So, enter a password. That's the password we set when we created it. We'll click on Unlock. Reveal drive. And there it is. It got assigned automatically drive E. We skipped over a number of the options. I'm just wanting to show you what this is about. So now I'm going to go ahead and just create a file here. New text document, secret.txt. We'll put some stuff in it. And we will then save it. Now, as it stands, with Cryptomator mounted, this file is accessible transparently using drive, in my case, E. However, if I now go back to Cryptomator and I lock that drive, the E drive goes away. And the only thing that's left are the encrypted files on my C drive. If I go to Documents, and I take a look at my Cryptomator example, you'll see it created a folder. And if I go in there now, there's stuff that honestly makes no sense, because it's the files and folders that are in that vault, except in their encrypted form. Only when you mount the volume can you see what's inside. So, good news, bad news, okay? The good news. Cryptomator provides high-quality encryption and is available on multiple platforms. It's highly suited to storing encrypted data on online storage services. Like VeraCrypt, your data is protected by a passphrase and is not tied to your login. Once it's mounted, encryption and decryption are completely transparent to any program reading and writing the data on the virtual drive. The bad news? Well, you can't easily copy individual files encrypted using Cryptomator to other machines in their encrypted form. The entire encrypted folder, in other words, in my example here, my Cryptomator example folder, would have to be copied in its entirety. That's the design. It's designed for cloud storage, where that naturally happens. That entire folder is replicated to the cloud, to other machines, and so forth. Extracting a single file is very difficult, if not nigh on impossible. All right, what's the bottom line here? Normally, I would make a recommendation as to which technology might be best. But this is a case where, honestly, these different tools solve the generic problem, how to encrypt a folder, in different ways that involve different trade-offs. You need to evaluate those trade-offs for yourself and balance them against your needs. What I can tell you is that I use Cryptomator a lot. I don't use operating system encryption at the file or folder level. I use cloud storage heavily, and Cryptomator ensures that anything I consider even slightly sensitive is stored securely encrypted. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/23097. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.